Yo, what's good YouTube? I'm back with another reaction video, and we got Larry Bird's triumphant return from injury, the NBA Showtime story. Definitely know this is going to be good when it comes to Larry Bird, man, coming back from his injury. So I'm excited to see this whole thing, his whole story and everything like that. But man, subscribe if you're new, hit that like button, turn on that bell. We upload it every single day, man. Deeply appreciate all love and support, man. I seen a lot of people like that Undisputed and Crazy, man. Skip and them they're crazy, man. But let's get straight to the video, man. Deeply appreciate y'all, man. Deeply appreciate y'all. And let's get straight into it, man. You know, I keep it short and sweet. Let's get it.
Palace of Auburn Hills, where the Pistons and Celtics are minutes away from the tip in Game 3 of what Chuck Daly has called the War of Attrition. For the Celtics, the war will be all but impossible to win without the aging and ailing 34-year-old Larry Bird. Well, his performance last Sunday is just another chapter in the legend of Larry, one that promises to continue in today's game.
You know, to his credit, he gets up and fights through it and goes out there and plays, but he is not a healthy person right now.
I've never met an athlete that would play with pain the way he does, and an athlete that's so highly self-motivated as Larry Bird.
I think 4 or 5 years, you'll think back about what he did, or you'll just, you know, you'll go that. I think it's one of those things that as the years go by, it'll become bigger and bigger and bigger.
We've come to expect great things from Larry Bird. That's why it may take years to truly appreciate the last 7 days. Sunday, the fifth and deciding game against the Pacers, in a desperate dive for a loose ball, Bird is knocked senseless. He leaves a close contest, heads for the locker room, and Boston falters. When Bird re-entered the Garden in the third quarter, the game instantly became secondary, the score an afterthought. Another verse was being added to Celtics lore. The last blow Chuck Person landed in his series-long battle with Bird was to the back that will require surgery in the offseason. But Bird was there at the end for the victory, adding to the legend of Larry Bird.
I've known Chuck for a while, and we've always had run-ins, but it always seems like I get the last word.
Maybe not. The wear and tear of the Pacers series kept Bird out of Tuesday's second round opener against the Pistons. Detroit rolled. They overpowered a confused Celtic team, a team that managed only 75 points without their captain.
I mean, I think it's really a mental thing that, you know, Larry's on the court now. Hey, now we got our leader back. We got a big option here we can go to down the stretch during the game. And he's just a big emotional lift when he's on the court, too.
Thursday morning, hours before tip-off, Larry Bird entered an empty Boston Garden. Still not sure if he'd play in game 2.
Man, he got swag. I don't care what nobody say. I will wear that. He got swag, man.
But on this day, Bird flew again. Only 24 hours earlier, he could hardly walk. He scored 16 points in the game, but his real contribution was his on-court presence. He guided a Celtic team that lacked poise and leadership in game 1. The fact that a man in that much pain could play so well elevated an entire team. And suddenly the series was tied at a game apiece.
I haven't done any extra shooting in 6 weeks, so it's a guess every time he goes up there.
Until we prove that we can win without him, until we prove that we're capable of getting the job done with him not being there, the Bird questions are going to keep coming. So it's really on us.
Even as he boarded the plane for Detroit yesterday, Bird knew that if the Celtics are to win a 17th title, he will have to lead them there.
Well, like Bird, the Pistons' injured star is really incredibly tough. Isaiah comes back much earlier than expected from the wrist injury. Today, he'll try to grit it out with the ankle injury, too.
Well, we go back to the Kevin McHale rule. Enunciated the other night after game 2. He said, when their best player is out, we win, and when our best player is out, they win. So today, they're both here, and I think it's going to be a great game.
They're both expected to play. They'll both be short of 100%. We can't wait to see how it comes out. We'll sit back and enjoy it with the rest of you. We turn it over to Marv Albert and Mike Fratello from the Palace of Auburn Hills right after this, and then we'll see you at halftime.
Hey, that was a good one right there. That was a good one. Damn, it was so short, but hey, it is what it is. I love seeing that. So that was the time I remember we seen that video when he got hit in his back. See, that's why I love doing these videos, y'all, because it's like certain highlights and stuff of videos I see, and then now we go like behind the backstory of everything, like how and showing like that. Yo, this, I'm glad I found this video, man. They're starting to give me some new videos too. Like that's how I was able to get that one. You know, like damn, like see, because I remember seeing that video. I remember we saw that when he hit and smashed his face, I think, on the ground or something like that. And then the guy came and hit him in his back and all that. Now I get to see behind that whole thing. I had like that. Yeah, that was a good one right there. But anyway, man, I don't want to do too much talking. Subscribe if you're new. Hit that like button. Turn on that bell, man. We uploading every single day, man. I deeply appreciate all love and support. And yeah, y'all know the streak. We gonna keep going, man. Gonna keep going, man. But yeah, that's about it, man. Y'all got some comments? I said comments. Well, if y'all do got comments, of course, leave them down below, because I try to my best to reply to everybody. I'm trying to be with different YouTuber, you know, like I'm trying to be the one that actually really reply back to everybody, because I can see people with like millions and thousands of subs and they don't never reply, like, you know, like, nah, man, I sit there and take my time to read y'all stuff and really reply back as much as I can. I don't think I've really missed too many of y'all comments at all. Like, I really try to reply back. But anyway, man, on to the next video, man. If y'all got some videos, leave them down in the comments. That's what I was trying to say. But, yeah, I deeply, deeply appreciate y'all. And I love y'all so much, man. But, yeah, I'm out. Love y'all. Peace.